What's up, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about adding an iSCSI into VMware ESXi 7.0. So let's get right into it. All right, so I am actually logged in into my disk station, which is a Synology Disk Station 1 DS118. Right now, I have the SAN manager already installed and configured. I already have a lung, which is already healthy. We are going to click on host, click on add, click on start, and I need to get I need to add an initiator. So I am going to go into my hypervisor, and within my hypervisor, I'm going to click on storage. We're going to go inside adapters and then click on software iSCSI. And by default, it is disabled, so we are going to enable it. From here, it is going to give us our initiator, our address. So I'm going to highlight it, copy it, and then click on save configuration, then go back inside my Synology, give it a name, click on add initiator, and then paste that hypervisor address that we copied, right? Just paste it and almost done. Click on next. We're definitely going to give it read and write permission. Click on next, and then you're done, right? Almost. So we need to head back inside our hypervisor, and within the hypervisor, we need to click on configure iSCSI. So within here, we need to give it a static target. So click on add static target, and we need to give it the address for the target. So head back inside your Synology, and within your SAN manager, go inside iSCSI, and then copy the IQN address, which is your initiator, right? So from there, once you copy it, we're going to head back inside your hypervisor and we're going to paste it. And we're also going to give it the IP address of your Synology as well. Now, the next thing that we need to do is give it a dynamic target. So we're going to click on add dynamic target. And for the address, you're going to give it the Synology disk station IP address. And the default port is 3260, so you don't need to change that at all. And then click on save configuration. And then within devices, you're going to see a new iSCSI disk, which is from Synology. If you highlight it, it gives you all this information as well as the capacity. And if you go inside data store, you're going to see your new iSCSI. How awesome is that? And that's beautiful, right? So next thing that I had to do within my environment is I needed to establish a connection to my hypervisor and then directly go inside that iSCSI location and drag and drop some of my virtual machines into that location so I could open them up and register them inside that hypervisor and start working. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.